About Battle of Plassey. After Aliwardi Khan, the Nawab of Bengal, he died in the year 1756. In the year 1756, Aliwardi Khan died, and next Nawab that was Siraj ud Dawla, he was the new ruler or new Nawab. When he became the new Nawab, he asked the Britishers to pay the tax, but the Britishers were not ready to pay the tax. They disrespect this Siraj ud Dawla as well as his officials. Then Siraj ud Dawla become very angry. He was very angry. Siraj ud Dawla become very angry. He decided to fight with the Britishers. So what he did is that with 30,000 soldiers. How many soldiers? 30,000 soldiers. He reached Qasim Bazar. Who reached Siraj, the infuriated or the angry Siraj ud Dawla with the 30,000 soldiers. He reached Qasim Bazar and defeated the factory at Qasim Bazar. He defeated the factory. Which factory? British factory that was defeated by, who defeated Siraj ud Dawla. This was very much, this created very much angry to whom? This created very much angry to the Britishers. The Britishers, they came to know the news that Siraj ud Dawla defeated the factory in Qasim Bazar. They tried to understood that they got a defeat. Under the leadership of Robert Clive, he led the army and reached Plassey and defeated whom? He defeated Siraj ud Dawla. Siraj ud Dawla got a crushing defeat by the hands of Robert Clive, because Robert Clive was an able ruler as well as a good administrator. He defeated Governor General also. He defeated Siraj ud Dawla, and this Siraj ud Dawla got a crushing defeat in the year 1757. That battle came to be known as Battle of Plassey. That battle we can call it as Battle of Plassey. I hope that you understood the Battle of Plassey. Who defeated whom? Under the leadership of Robert Clive, the Governor General, under the command of Robert Clive, he defeated Siraj ud Dawla. This war had an importance. Why this war had an importance? Because the Battle of Plassey became famous. This battle became very much famous because it was the first major victory of the company won in India. Then the company become the rulers. The company got a great victory. So I hope that you understood the Battle of Plassey. Now listen, after the defeat at Plassey, Siraj ud Dawla was assassinated. Then Siraj ud Dawla was killed. Who killed? The Britishers killed Siraj ud Dawla and made Mir Jafar. Mir Jafar was the commander. Mir Jafar, he was the commander of Siraj ud Dawla. Siraj ud Dawla's commander was Mir Jafar. But Mir Jafar did nothing in the battlefield. He did not fight for Siraj ud Dawla. So, Britishers gave promise to Mir Jafar, given promise. that he will be appointed as the new Nawab. So Mir Jafar become very much happy because he now become the new Nawab. He become the new Nawab. Who become the new Nawab? Mir Jafar. He become the new Nawab. Who appointed? Britishers appointed Mir Jafar as the new Nawab. So the company decided that he become a puppet ruler, but he become a puppet ruler. Whatever the Britishers will tell, who will obey? Mir Jafar will do everything. This Mir Jafar will do everything. He will do everything of the company. What a company will tell, he will obey. Whose expectation, the company expectation was like this. But sometimes the company understood that these rulers will not obey some time. So they find it difficult to make them obey. So they decided to overthrow Mir Jafar. Company understood that certain circumstances they are not obeying. They become puppet rulers. So company understood the situation. Mir Jafar sometimes, even Mir Jafar also protested the company. So he was deposed. Who was deposed? Mir Jafar was deposed. Mir Jafar, now he was deposed from power. Instead of Mir Jafar, they appointed Mir Qasim. Who was appointed? Mir Qasim was now appointed. Mir Qasim become very much happy now. He become very much happy. Who become very much happy? Mir Qasim become very much happy. Now, instead of Mir Jafar, he was deposed. He was deposed, and who become the new Nawab? Mir Qasim become the new Nawab. But their expectation was Mir Qasim become like a puppet. He become like a puppet. He become the he will obey everything like a puppet. Mir Qasim will obey everything. But their expectation failed. When their expectation failed, their expectation also failed. Their expectation also failed. In that time, the Britishers understood that Mir Jafar also not obeying them. That time, Mir Qasim complained. He in turn was defeated in the battle fought at Buxar. That is called the Battle of Buxar. What is Battle of Buxar? Battle of Buxar here means Mir Qasim did not obey the Britishers. The Britishers, they defeat. Who defeated Britishers? Britishers, they defeated Mir Qasim. Mir Qasim was defeated. That battle came to be known as Battle of Buxar. Where this battle took place in Buxar, they defeated whom? Mir Qasim. That battle we can call it as Battle of Buxar. What is Battle of Plassey? Siraj Daula was defeated by the Britishers. That battle came to be known as Battle of Plassey. In which year? 1757. Which place? Plassey. Next, we started to do Battle of Buxar. Where it took place? Buxar. Whom? Mir Qasim was driven out. Mir Qasim was driven out. Why? Mir Qasim was driven out. He did not obey the British. He never want to become a puppet ruler. So he was also driven out. And in that time, they appointed again Mir Jafar. Mir Jafar. Then Mir Jafar now become the next. Again, he was reinstalled. He was reinstalled. Who was reinstalled? Mir Jafar was again reinstalled. Whom? The company reinstalled. Whom? Mir Jafar. Why? Because Mir Qasim did not obey the Britishers. So Mir Qasim was defeated by the British at the Battle of Buxar in 1764. And who was reinstalled? Mir Jafar once again reinstalled. Now, the Nawab had to pay rupees 5 lakh every month. Who will pay? This Nawab. Actually, this Nawab got power, but he had to pay how many rupees? 5 lakh rupees. Every month he had to pay 5 lakh rupees. But the company wanted more money to finance its wars. Company said that it was not enough for them because they need more finance. Why? Because of these continuous wars. War. And meet the demands of trade and other expenses. It wanted more territories and more revenue. The British demanded more revenues to whom? Mir Jafar. They asked to Mir Jafar more money rather than 5 lakh. So in this time, Mir Jafar, in 1765, Mir Jafar died. Mir Jafar died. He died. In which year? 1765, Mir Jafar died. Mir Jafar now died. Mir Jafar died. Mir Jafar died in the year 1765. So the mood of the company had changed. Again, the mood of the company changed. Having failed to work with the puppet Nawabs, Clive declared, we must indeed become Nawabs of ourselves. Now, what this Clive said, that we again, after the death of Mir Jafar, they said that we don't want again Nawab. We themselves become the Nawabs. Who said these words? We must indeed become, become Nawabs. Ourselves. Who said? Robert Clive said. Robert Clive said like this. When this Mir Jafar died in the year 1765. When Mir Jafar died in the year 1765, this Robert Clive said what he said. He said that we must indeed become the Nawabs of ourselves. Who said? Robert Clive said like this. So finally, in 1765, the Nawabs of Mughal Empire appointed company as the Diwan. Now, who become the Diwan? The company become the Diwan. Finally, in 1765, the Mughal Empire appointed the company become the Nawab. The company become the Diwan of the province of Bengal. And then the Britishers got the right. Which right? The right is called Diwani right. What is Diwani right? The right to collect tax from Bengal, Bihar, Orissa. The right to collect tax from Bengal, Bihar and Orissa. That we can call it as Diwani right. This is called Diwani right. Then now the British, they can collect tax from Bengal, Bihar and Orissa. So the company now got enough money. No need to get money from their homeland, from Britain. No need to get money from Britain. Now, no need. Because now they will get money from India itself. Because Diwani right. So they can collect tax from Bengal, Bihar and Orissa. So that the Britishers no need to worry. They will get money from India itself. So this helped them to conduct more war in India. Moreover, the revenues could be used to purchase these revenues. Now they got enough revenue. These revenue they can utilize to purchase cotton and silk, to establish a silk textiles in India. Silk textiles in India itself. Establish a revenue for cotton as well as silk textiles in India itself. Then now the company can maintain troops, military troops, and meet the cost of building, cost of building. If they can build many buildings, they can construct. Okay, they can construct even buildings also, because now they had a right to collect a tax from Bengal, Bihar and Orissa. Moreover, they have enough for revenue. They can maintain cotton as well as they can establish many silk textiles. Then they can build many buildings. So the company now got enough revenue from India itself. I hope that you understood this much.